Okay guys, welcome back with to our plant propagation class. So the topic today is registration, certification and regulation of vegetative seedling. And of course I only talk about Indonesian situation. I hope the international student can also get benefit from that, and I recommend you to also take a look to the original regulation document to know more about it. And of course this is a dynamic thing, the regulation is a dynamic thing, year by year they are changing so many things. So next year for instance you need to update the knowledge and information about registration, certification and regulation of this vegetative seedling. Just give you an idea that why we should do the registration, yeah, and also regulation, certification, is that based on Republic of Indonesian law, such as number 13 in 2010 concerning horticulture, in the article 35, the circulated horticultural facility must meet quality standards and be registered. So also it covers about the seed, yeah, and even vegetative seedling. And in article 52 for instance, the horticultural business as referred to the article 50, yeah, about seed must be registered, yeah. And the registration as referred into paragraph 1 before shall be carried out by the governments and or regional governments, yeah. And the seed business can only done by business actor who have a competency certificate. So if you want to be a good citizen, yeah, good businessman, you should also think about fulfilling this competency certificate. And it is not really hard to get it, yeah. You just need that to show your competency, and you need to show that you are have permission to use some facilities, and this is okay. Or even you can buy your own facilities, yeah, it's okay. And then the selling of seed, yeah, or distributing seed material will not be applied to individual or groups that carry out the seed business for their own use, yeah, and or are limited to one group, yeah. So this is common scheme of seed distribution and certification, yeah. Here is first you need to do the variety registration. And then after that, it become mother plants, yeah, or cluster plants. And after that, the certification seed can be applied. First is the registration of variety. Yeah, so quality seeds of superior variety, it states in horticultural law as well. And superior varieties come from breeding activities that can be carried out by individuals, companies and government agency. And maybe you get this slide also from Professor Sobir, yeah, from another course. This is about the scheme from the breeding. So this is the SGD, it means that our genetic resources, yeah, so the genetic resources here. It can be a protected variety, can be just a variety, and also a wet relative genotype, yeah. And after that, the people do the breeding program, yeah, to get the new varieties. And after they get the new varieties, to protect the work, the hard work, yeah, of the breeders, we can do the plant protection program, and the dust testing here is will be applied, the distinct, unique and stable, yeah. And the result, it can also be considered as a genetic resource. But if you only do this scheme, so you cannot sell it, yeah, because this scheme is only to protect the breeder, yeah. But what you should do to get permission to distribute it in a commercial way, you need to do the release variety, yeah. It will become a superior variety, and this is commercial seed, yeah, not sales seed, commercial seed, and it can be distributed, yeah. And the scheme is meant to protect the consumer, yeah, because consumer will be protected to get the real variety they want to buy, yeah. Okay, and the excellences of the variety, it can be about the productivity, yeah, and it can be about the resistance to pests and disease, stress resistance, and fruit with no seasonal production, long storage and not easily broken, or it can also should have an ideal morphology, the unique shape of the organs, and it has a high market value and maybe also superior rootstock. The clonal propagation, like what we already discussed many times, it's obligatory to produce a large amount of annual fruits and vegetable seed, yeah, with the guarantee of the correctness variety. It will be implemented using a single mother plants. In Indonesia, we call it PIT or pohon induk tunggal, or population parent clump, yeah, rumpun induk, yeah, of registered variety, yeah, for circulation. And propagation of the system can be implemented in stages through the first foundation block, and then the scion multiplication block, yeah, and seed propagation block. Arrangement of parent trees and parent clump is needed so that the clonalization system runs well, so that the superiority and purity of the parent variety can be maintained and maintained for generation. Yeah. And the arrangement of the mother plants or parent family, rumpun induk, is done through PI or RI determination, yeah. For instance, the description of the varieties will be compared with the original ones, and assessment such as to assess the traceability, maintaining the correctness of variety, and also visibility such as the crop condition, yeah, plant health, productivity, and estimated ability to produce source of propagation material. And then we should also do the monitoring of pohon induk and rumpun induk to monitor the feasibility of pohon induk and rumpun induk 2 years from the date of stipulation or at any time if necessary. This is schematic scheme, yeah, of the single mother plant, pohon induk tunggal. This is the single mother plants, and then it will be propagated in a foundation block. In Indonesia, we call it, after that we certified as a benih dasar, yeah, foundation seed. And after that, we clone this plant and put it in the scion multiplication block, yeah, and it will be labeled as a benih pokok, and after that we do in the propagation block, yeah, to get the certified seed. And there's some exemption for citrus, for instance, yeah, and also for the certification program. The citrus is very sensitive to virus attack, therefore for pohon induk or single mother plant, and also for foundation block, it will be keep in the greenhouse, like this, for reducing the risk of contamination made by virus. And this is for RIP or rumpun induk, yeah. For instance, for banana, salak, or snake fruits, and pineapple. Generally it's similar. So from this, we propagate in the foundation block, yeah, and a multiplication for a cluster, and then after that in the propagation block. And I will give you illustration of needs why we should do the clonal propagation, because for instance, this is just in 2020 actually we need this number of seedling, yeah. This is for citrus, we need 442,000, but and this is just the demand from the government, yeah. So from the Director General of Horticulture, it's not from the private sector. Maybe this number will be more increased. This is just example from the government side. And then for mango, we need this number, yeah, and mangosteen, and also for another crops. So this is for fruit plant seed certification program. It's based on the Ministry of Agriculture Regulation number 42 in 2019, so it's relatively new. There's a regulation and standard operational procedure for doing that, so I recommend you to also take a look at the original document, yeah. So it regulates so many things, from the requirement of the rootstock, for instance, the mother plant, yeah, and etc. So this is the planting pattern of plant from the clonal system, yeah. So first we need to register, yeah. This is the register activity, and then after that we should do the what we call it in Indonesia kebenaran varietas, so the variety checking, yeah. And after that it will be distributed to the foundation block, yeah, and cyan multiplication block and plant propagation blocks, and in the end to the farmers to buy it. And this process is under suspicion of the what we call it in Indonesia BPSB, yeah, or agency for seed certification and monitoring. And the point of the regulation number 42 is intended to provide a reference for the supervisor of plant seed and plant quality assurance in order to carry out the certification of fruit plant seed, yeah, properly and correctly, so that the quality seeds are obtained in accordance with the applicable regulation. And the aim of the regulation is to increase, yeah, the quality of the fruit seed in Indonesia, yeah, through seed certification program. So based on the regulation, fruit plant seed certification include the seed certification resulting from vegetative propagation. Yeah, so it's not only this, but this is the one that are related to our course. So seed certification from vegetative propagation, starting from cyan and trace and cutting, and then grafting and budding, layering, comb, crown, and sucker, and also vegetative seeds such as apomixis. And also it regulates the minimum technical requirement. What is that? We will discuss it afterward. So there are 48 plants regulated in this guideline, in this regulation, starting from avocado, etc. Yeah, and this number is always increased time by time. And SIT certification provider is the agency of work unit that carry out tasks in the field of supervision and certification of horticulture SIT, and also can be the producer itself, but it should has a quality management system certificate. Yeah, they should register first, and they will make assessment if the SIT producer can do the system certification system by themselves or not. And the applicant should has a certificate of competency for producing horticulture seed. Yeah. So if you want to have a nursery and you want to have your seed are certified, you need to apply for this first. And when they grant a certificate to you, then you can do the propagation. And they will give you the certificate for your propagative result. Yeah, and first is the certification of scion and trees and cutting, the seed source. It should be a mother plant that have been registered. Yeah, so the mother plant should be registered, and then the mother plant should be healthy, suitable as source of seed, meet minimum technical requirements. You can see that in the annex of the regulation, and the seed class produced is the same as the source of the seed class. Yeah, and if the legality of the source seed is not able to be traced because it's already registered a long time ago, then the seed source should be genetically identical to the duplicate of the PIT, or you can consult with the breeder, and even you should show the DNA test of your mother plant. And unit certification for scion and trace and cutting material are only for one variety, one seed class, one time multiplied in one location, with the maximum number of one unit certification is 20,000 scions. Yeah, so if you want to certify more, then you should register for more unit certification. And there will be examination made by the BPSB. It will check the correct location, the seed source. It will check the suitability of the type, variety, class of seed, health, etc. And it inspect your parent trees. And it will come to you when you are taking scions and trees, and also material for cuttings. And the parent tree has to be recorded or registered in the agency. And what they examine is such as the validity of the also the document, the usability of the description of the parent plants, and etc. Okay, next is the certification of grafting and budding. For this, at least there are two requirement condition. First is for the scion and also for the rootstock. The scions should be come from varieties that are already registered, yeah, and etc. Mostly are the same with the previous ones. And the second is the rootstock. Yeah, for the rootstock, the varietal requirement is different here. It's just for the orange or citrus. For orange or citrus, the variety should have been released or registered or recommended by the government. Yeah. And why is that? Because the citrus, like what I mentioned before, is really sensitive or susceptible to virus. And based on experience sometimes ago, the virus can devastate it. The citrus production, yeah, it's very hard. So some production area of citrus are really, really bad at that time. So they now try to limit the spread of the virus starting from the seedling. Yeah. So for the orange, there are specific requirements. But for other plants, then rather than orange, they can use the same variety, yeah, or other variety. Yeah. And the technical requirement is that the plant grow in normal and healthy condition, and it should be compatible with the top stem, and specifically for orange, there should be also selection of new cellular seedling, such as removing the generative or off-type seedling, and also removing the curve and curve root seedling like this. Yeah, this is not good. And the unit of certification of grafting and budding, it depends if you the objective of your grafting and budding is to duplicate the PIT. So is the maximum is only for 50 plants, and for the foundation block it's about 250 plants, and etc. Yeah, and this is for the register seed. It can be up to 10,000 plants. Yeah, this is the illustration what we have done. This is the duplicate mother plant in for IPB in Subang. We duplicate the longan, durian, and also avocado at the time. And the examination will be also carried out. It starts from the pre-planting. They check before the grafting or budding, and the factor examined are the location, source of seed, and availability and feasibility of the rootstock. Yeah, so they check the plant, how many rootstock they can produce. Yeah, and because they will make a you know, some people they say just we can produce something like that, but when they check, the mother plants look like not enough to do that much propagation. So the BPSB will try to investigate from which plant you get the scion or you get the rootstock. Yeah, so they also will check the feasibility of the plant. And then first planting check, and such as the grafting height, top grafting, and lower stem insertion, plant health, and success rate of the grafting and budding. And the second inspection includes the suitability of description, plant health, uniformity, etc. Yeah, and the result is okay, then they declare it as good, and after that they will give the label. On the label containing this information, such as the name of the producer, the address of the producer, the type of the plant, etc., and also the date when you do the grafting or budding, and the check date and the serial numbers, and they will give a yellow for breeder seed, white for foundation seed, purple for stock seed, and blue for extension seed. And usually farmer they buy the blue label seed, yeah, for production. This is the example, the blue labeled seed from our nursery, and we distribute to the many parts of Indonesia. And next is the certification of seeds from layering. So the seed source should be from the variety that are already registered. So basically the requirement here is similar with the previous one, so I will not repeat that. And this is the difference, that one unit certification is one variety, one class of seed, one time multiplied in one location, with the maximum number is also I think also almost similar, that the duplicate of the mother plant is about only maximum 50 plants, and for foundation seed is 250 plants, and so on. And the examination more or less also similar, but here after the first and the second inspection, they also do the examination in the container. I mean, after you separate or detach from the mother plant, you put it in the container, right? And after that, they also do examination of your plant in the container, and inspection is about the suitability of the description, plant growth, plant health, uniformity of growth, and etc. And certification of seedling from sucker, comb, and crowns. And plants that are certified through this propagation are bananas, snake fruit, pineapple, and red fruit. And this is also similar, yeah. I think some points are exactly the same. So it should be the variety comes from this variety that already registered or released, yeah. And the mother plant should be healthy, etc. And even the DNA testing thing also mentioned here. So certification of seedling from sucker, comb, and crown here. For the seed classification, a cluster of mother plant or a duplicate, yeah, are classified as a breeder seed. And when it transfer in the foundation block, then classified as a foundation seed, yeah, and so on. And the unit certification, the maximum number, yeah, is like this. Yeah, for extension seed, it can up to 25,000 plants. And there's also examination before activities. Yeah, we call it preliminary examination. And the factor examined here is the correctness of the location, source of seed, and etc. And also another examination, such as when it's already in the container, you transfer it in the container, and they will do also inspection in the figure, health, seed health, and amount of seed that fulfill the condition or requirement. Last is the vegetative seed certification, yeah, for apomixis. Plants included in this propagation are mangosteen, and in Indonesia we call it a duku. And the seed source will be from the mother plant varieties that have been registered, yeah? And the mother plant should be in healthy, suitable as source of seed, and it meets the minimum technical requirement in accordance with the commodity and class of the seed. And the seed source of the seed class must be higher than the class of seed produced. And also, if the legally of the source seed is not be able to be traced, then you should need to do even the DNA test here, or you can ask the breeder. And classification here, sorry, this is not season but seed classification. Seed propagated from seed or seedling can be classified as certified seed or extension seed, yeah. So when the certification system are fulfilled, and they can be certified. And the certification unit here is that the one unit of seed certification in the form of young plant, so it should be a seedling derived from the seed, that should be one variety, one seed class, and one program at one location. The maximum number of seed is 20,000 seeds, and the difference of planting time is a maximum 30 day in one certification unit. So you should really take care about the facilities and also the availability of seed you are collected in one program. And examination carry out at the time of seed collection, and then they will examine the mother plants, yeah, register or not, and it should be in healthy condition, and so on. And so during the planting checks, 7 working days before ready to be disseminated, including the suitability of the description, figure, and also plant health. This is the example of this is the example of the minimum technical requirements. In Indonesia we call it PTM for certification of fruit plant seed, yeah. Sorry, in Indonesia, but I can explain to you, this is the variety and should be compatible, and this is the grow, it should be in a good shape, diameter, age of plant, etc. Yeah, so you should fill this requirement. Yeah, and for citrus, for instance, it should be free from disease, yeah, and also the number of leaf, etc. Yeah, and in potato, it's even become very difficult. Yeah. So, for instance, here the nematode infection should be 0%, and the virus should be 0% for the G0 and G1 class, but for the G2, you can get 1% virus infection, etc. And this is example production of disease-free orange seed. Disease is the main factor determining the seed production of citrus. This is the main disease in orange. Sorry for this. This is by vectors, and also this is by non-vector. This one, the first one, CVPD, is the one that are really dangerous, yeah, in citrus production in Indonesia. Therefore, we try to avoid this one. And this is the process flow of the parent tree production. Yeah, so first we should do the selection of candidate of mother plant, and then after that we do the grafting and budding, and do the indexing. And after that, we got the mother plant here, and then put it in the propagated in the foundation block and scion multiplication block, and then after that distribute to the seed producer, and they can get and they will produce the extension seed, and it will be distributed to the farmer. And this is under monitor of the PPSB. So for citrus, again, we need to put it in the close greenhouse like this to avoid the insect vector to come and infest the plant. And after that, we this is the example from the Bali Gestro, so from Indonesian Citrus and Subtropical Fruit Research Institute. They produce the purple label seed, and then distribute to the seed producer to produce the extension seed. And this is an example of potato. So the G0 free from pathogen and especially virus is produced by tissue culture, and then after that we can do cutting from the tissue culture and from the ex vivo plant in the greenhouse for mini tuber production. And mini tuber are planted to produce G1 in a greenhouse, then planted to produce G2 in the field. I already showed this picture to you. So this is from the mother tuber. We can get many plants in this in vitro culture, and then that we can make a cutting, yeah, and produce a G0 or even directly produce G2 in the field. And also we can produce G1 in the greenhouse, G0 and the G1 in the greenhouse before. And obligation of producer is that they need to obey the law and regulation in the field of seed, yeah, business, and then responsible for the quality of seed produce, and reporting production activities periodically to the head of district or city service office in charge of seedling with a copy to the agency, and also documentation of the production activity. And there's also penalty for that, yeah. And in Indonesian situation, the penalty can be up to 2 billion rupiah, and also 2 years maximum jail, yeah. Okay, and like what I said before, the regulation is dynamic. The example of this is that in potato, for instance, before 2015, the extension seed was G4. And during the 2015 to 2019, or I would say up to now, the extension seed was G2, because at the time we need the production acceleration, and also that the G4 tuber already contaminated with so many kind of disease, especially virus. Therefore, our government say that using G2, it will benefit to the farmers and the environment. But in 2019, there are discussion about to change to G3 because the G2 certification is too short. Yeah, so maybe it will be changed after this. And example in salads before 2017, there was no tuber class, yeah, like a potato tuber fortification system. So we don't know in the salad how many generation farmers already use the seed, yeah, because they're relying on purity done by the seed producer. And using seed purity, using bulb, the virus cannot be eliminated. Yeah, and the TSS or true seed of salad can be certified after 2017. And in 2021, maybe the eliminating virus in vitro for salad will be also applied. Yeah, I don't know. And the other example that regulation is dynamic is that, see here, the Ministry of Agriculture Regulation number 48 in 2012 is already replaced in 2013, so just 1 year. Yeah? And even for technical certification of horticulture seed, regulation number 15 in 2018 concerning only 44 commodities is already changed in 2019 based on the regulation number 42. Yeah, so I assume that because the regulation is dynamic, so in the next future, maybe 1 year, there will be also improvement or a change in the regulation. So if you are interested to be a farm manager or nursery or seed producer, you should be aware about that change. So thank you very much for your attention. I expect some feedback from you, and thank you very much.